We're smack in the middle of northern Chatham, and it's one of the most amazing landscapes that you can see. It's peppered with all these little volcanic cones. These little volcanoes all erupted on the sea floor, and since they erupted, this part of the world has been pushed up tectonically. Amazing. So what we're looking at is actually an exhumed sea floor with these little volcanoes, more or less as they were when they were actually erupted. Here you can see the fragmented nature of the rock, which is absolutely typical of volcanic submarine volcanism. We can see Matakitaki, which is the northwesternmost little volcanic cone in northern Chatham. And then over here, this pointy one is Mount Diefenbach. And you can see there are chains of these. It turns out that these little volcanoes are in alignment. There are several lines of these little cones, and the lines must relate to weaknesses within the Earth's crust, basically fault lines. Okay, and now we're looking in the opposite direction, well, north actually, and you can see the Sisters, another submarine volcano that erupted about 5 million years ago. And further off, we can see Hikarangi, the dark headland, and then Cape Young, and further right, we can see Waikawa. So the place is peppered with small submarine volcanoes. But between the volcanoes, we have this very flat landscape. Essentially, it's an old sea floor. We start off with basement schist, part of Gondwana, and Zealandia separates from Gondwana. Zealandia sank from late Cretaceous time down, and it just continued to sink. So about 65 million years ago, everything here was submarine. And these little volcanoes erupted at the same time as there was deep marine sedimentation, limestones, etc., that accumulated on the deep ocean floor. And then it's all come back up, and all the soft sediments have eroded away, and we're just left with these little volcanoes sitting on top of the schist.